This is the Sahalis hemoglobinometer. Hemoglobinometer pipette. There is a 20 microliter mark on hemoglobinometer pipette up to which we have to fill the blood. Hemoglobinometer tube. There are two types of markings on hemoglobinometer tube. One shows hemoglobin gram percentage value and another shows percentage value. Usually hemoglobin is reported as grams of hemoglobin per 100 ml, which means gram per dl or gram percentage. Comparator box, which have color strip. A bottle, which contains N by 10 HCl. Here the N means normality. Define normality, or what is normal solution. When 1 gram equivalent weight of a substance is dissolved in 1 liter of the solvent is called one normal solution. Can we use normal HCl or any strong acid or alkali? No, we cannot use, because it will cause destruction of proteins which are present in the hemoglobin, and hemoglobin value will alter. Stirrer or glass rod, which used for mixing purpose. Distilled water for dilution purpose. Instead of distilled water, can we use N by 10 HCl for dilution? Yes, we can, but we are not using it because of economic reasons. Instead of distilled water, can we use tap water? No, because it's not pure and contains microorganisms. Principle of Sahalis method. The amount of hemoglobin can be estimated by conversion of known volume of blood into acid hematin by addition of dilute HCl, which means N by 10 HCl, and calorimetric comparison with a suitable standard. Now we begin with the procedure. With the help of dropper, fill N by 10 HCl in hemoglobinometer tube up to its lowest marking, which means up to 2 gram percentage yellow marking. Put hemoglobinometer tube in a comparator box. Prick your finger. Which finger you are going to prick? Only prick middle finger or ring finger in its distal part, as you are seeing in the photograph. Why? Because palmar fascia of thumb, index finger and little finger extend to the forearm. If we prick these fingers and infection occur, there are chances that it might spread to the forearm. Apply spirit swab over the pricking area, and we have to wait till the spirit has been dry. Why we have to wait till the spirit has been dry? If we prick before the spirit has been dry, the blood which coming out from the pricking area get mixed with the spirit and it gets hemolyzed. So we need to wait till the spirit has been dry. Take a lancet and prick distal part of the finger. Only single prick. Avoid multiple pricking. With the help of hemoglobinometer pipette, suck the blood up to 20 microliter marking. Draw the blood in the hemoglobinometer tube, as you are seeing in the photographs. Mix contents thoroughly and put hemoglobinometer tube in a comparator box. Wait for 10 minutes. During this time, hemoglobin is converted to acid hematin, which looks brown in color. If less than required amount of HCl is taken, then it may not be enough to convert all the hemoglobin which is present in 20 microliter of blood to acid hematin, hence give lower value for hemoglobin. After 10 minutes, add distilled water drops till the color of the solution is same as that of the comparator box color strip. When you are adding distilled water, mix the solution with the help of stirrer. The color of the acid hematin solution should be checked frequently to prevent over dilution. When you compare the color of the solution with that of standard comparator box color strip, keep the stirrer above the solution but do not take it out. If the stirrer is taken out of the tube, the solution sticking to the stirrer will be lost and will give a false low result. If the stirrer remains in the solution, the color of the solution becomes lighter. Comparison should always be done by holding the comparator box with hemoglobinometer tube at eye level and stirrer slightly lifted above the solution, but must not be taken out of the tube. When color of the solution is same as comparator box color strip, hold the tube, lift the stirrer up and look for readings in hemoglobin gram percentage as you are seeing in the right photograph. Here are the normal values of the hemoglobin. At birth, it is around 23 gram per dl, slightly higher because RBC count is more. In adult male, it is around 14 to 18 gram per dl and in adult female, it is around 12 to 15.5 gram per dl.